Put your arms around them and praise the Lord. Come on, greet your neighbor. Tell them that you love them. Put your arms around them and praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. All over the room, praise the Lord. If you're glad to be in God's house,
just one more time, just one more time. Lord, I am glad to be in the service one more time. Oh, one more time, one more time, one more time, just one more time. Lord, I am glad to be in the service one more time. Well, if my grandmother was here today,
oh yeah,
these are the words you would hear her say. Lord, I am glad to be in the service one more time.
Sunday morning, this Sunday after the celebration, this Sunday after the turkey and dressing, this Sunday after folks have gone home and gone their separate ways. We're thankful to God for this opportunity of worship, fellowship, prayer, and praise. We thank God for each of you. Thank God also for the loyal members of the Bethel Missionary Baptist Church and all of our loyal friends out there in the virtual environment. We thank you again that you join us to share in the worship and praise and share the blessings of God as He has brought us together again toward the end of the year, the end of the month. We're still in the holidays. We thank God for all of the blessings that He has bestowed us on us all year long as we're preparing to close out another year. Again, we greet you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Thank God. We're going to ask you to continue to pray for those who are sick, those in the hospital. Remember those who are going through a time of bereavement, that God would comfort and keep them. Thank you again. Pray for those behind walls of confinement, whether they be walls of penal institutions, walls of mental institutions, hospitals, wherever, nursing facility, rehabilitation facilities, or the walls of your home. We thank God for you this morning. We're going to go forth as we know our normal procedure, our normal order is. We're going to ask you to prepare. At the end of this year, we're thankful for this opportunity of worship through giving. We want to remind you of the various ways of giving. We thank God for them. Even though you're not able to be here, you can give online by going to our website and following the prompts. If you want your contribution to go directly into the financial accounting system of Bethel Missionary Baptist Church, we ask you to press the RAM button. If you have other means of giving you want to use, it's your preference. Giblify, PayPal, text, or whatever, Cash App. We'll be glad to receive that. Amen. So you can follow the prompts, or you can put it in the mail, or you can bring it by the church from 9 to 1 Mondays and Thursdays. Amen. Amen. We again thank God for the privilege of worship. As you have prepared your offering, we're going to ask that you now, amen, we're going to ask God's blessing over the offering. As you, wherever you are, let's give thanks to God. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for this again, a privilege of worshiping you through giving of the substance that you have given to us. And oh God, we thank you for all of your gifts. No matter the gift is, it is finite or infinite, whether the gift is seen or whether it is unseen, whether, oh God, whether it is tangible or intangible, we thank you for them now. And we pray now, God, that you would receive these gifts. And we ask you to bless the giver in the name of Jesus. And we pray that you would bless them even to 100-fold. For we ask these and other blessings in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Amen.
The Lord, He's blessing us right now. Oh, right now. Y'all know that the Lord,
oh, yes, He is.
Is blessing me.
Yes, He is.
Right now. Right
now.
Oh.
Oh, right now. Right now.
He woke me up.
He woke me up. Early.
And He started. Oh, yes, He did.
The Lord.
He keeps right on.
He really
is blessing me.
Yeah.
Right now.
Yeah.
Right now. Oh, let's say that one more time. The Lord.
The Lord.
The Lord is.
The Lord is blessing me.
Oh, yes, He is. Right now.
Yes, He is.
Oh, right now.
Blessing me.
Oh, right now.
thankful again for your loyal support. We thank God for what you do and what you're doing, and thank God for what you have already done. Amen. We thank God for this privilege again. We're going to go forth. We want to remind each of us that the year is coming to a close. We want to remind that we will have a virtual watch service. I got a little surprise for you. Amen. We do our normal time. It will be virtual, but we'll do our normal time. I think it's 7. I think it should come up 7 on the watch night or the New Year Eve service. Should be on. You can view it. Should be viewing about, I think it was 6. I think it'll be quiet time. 6 o'clock. The 31st of December, you can join us on the website at 6 o'clock, and the 31st, December the 31st, as we prepare, amen, for the new year. We hope to have a surprise for you. Amen. Let's not spoil you. Amen. But we want you to tune in to us for that 6 o'clock, amen, virtually. Amen. You can do it on YouTube, or you can do it, amen, on Facebook. We'll be glad, amen, for you to join us. Amen. We're going to ask you to pray for all of the sick, the shut-in, wherever they are, those who've been in the hospital. We thank God for it. We thank God for good news. We thank God for those persons who have been in the hospital and are now recuperating home, Sister Angela Underwood. Amen. We thank God for Sister all of those who have been in the hospital, been there with others in the hospital. Let's continue to pray for them. One of the twins, I forgot now which one, she let me know the day that she was at home. Let's keep them in our prayers. Brother Anderson Clayton, who's also charged. Amen. We thank God for answered prayer for all of those who have been sick. Let's keep them in our prayers, and God will continue to strengthen and keep them. Sister Vivian, with for the opportunity of having shared some time with you. We ask you to continue to pray for Sister Vivian Rendell, that God will continue to strengthen her and touch her right where she is, as well as Sister Sophia. We ask you to pray for them. That's prayers and on a prayer list, wherever they are. All of those, especially prayer. Special prayer goes out to our centenarians, Sister Emma Harvey, Brother George Darrington, and Sister Odell Woods. We send much love to you, as well as to all of our elderly. Amen. Whether where you are, whether you are confined at home, or whether you are able to move about, we send prayers up for you and prayer requests for you. Let's remember those who are sick. Pray for this nation and all of the turmoil that's going through. Those who are going through a time of bereavement, let's keep them in our prayers. Pray for our homes and families to keep the devil out of there. Because the thief comes but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Amen. He says, I stand at the door and knock. If any man, any woman, he would hear my voice, open up, I will come in and have sup with you. Amen. There he said, come, take the waters of life freely. Amen. God bless. We're going to ask you to bow your heads as we go to the throne of grace, throne of mercy, as we go to our Father in prayer. Shall we pray? Our Father, the creator and sustainer of all life, the one who walked out on the porch of nothingness and declared, let there be light, and there was. The one who was there in the beginning. Amen. The one who was with God and the one who was God. We come in that name, in the name of the one who became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory as of the only begotten of the Father. The name of Jesus, the Christ, the anointed one. We come in that name because we know that there is healing in that name. There's salvation in that name. Yahweh, the Lord, the Jehovah. We come thanking you, Father, for all of the things that you have blessed us with. Thank you for your goodness, your mercies. We thank you for the gift of your Son who came down through 42 generations and died and gave his life as a ransom. Yes, his blood he shed for the sin of the world. And we come in his name thanking you for the privilege of prayer. Thank you for, oh God, you have kept us thus far all year long. And you brought us to the precipice of another year. We thank you for these 12 months so far that you have brought us. You brought us into the last month in the year. And oh God, we want to thank you for you have brought us to the last Sunday in another year. And here we are saying thank you. Thank you because we were not so good. The reason why we were able to be here. For there are many who stood out on this journey, but somewhere you have allowed them, they had to exit this realm from time into eternity. But yet you allowed our golden moments to roll a little while longer. We want to say thank you. Not because we've been so righteous, but we know that if we have any righteousness, it is in Christ Jesus. For he that knew no sin became sin for us, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. And we thank you for our standing in him. Though we are creatures that are imperfect, we are creatures who have fallen short of the glory of God. And we thank you for forgiving our sins. Oh God, you said that if we would confess our sins, you would be faithful and just and would forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And so here we are, thanking you for the many blessings that you bestowed upon us. Thank you for this privilege of prayer. And we pray now in the name of Jesus that you would touch those who are listening, oh God, to this broadcast, listening to these service this morning, listening, waiting on you, waiting for a word from you, waiting for a touch from you, waiting for an encouragement from you, waiting for a lifting from you. Some are burdened and they're waiting, oh God, for you to lift their burden. Some are worried, oh God, but I know that you are rocking the weary land. Some are sick and they're waiting for the manifestation of your healing. We ask that you would touch, speak right now. Somebody don't know you in the pond of their sin. They are in a valley of decision, in a valley of despair. Touch them right now. Oh God, change them. Make them new creatures in Christ Jesus. For let the old things pass away and let all things become new in Christ. Oh God, we pray that you would touch those, oh God, who stand at the fork of the road, not knowing which way to go. But we ask God that you would give them the light so that they can walk therein. We pray for those who are in leadership positions. Oh God, we pray for that you would give them wisdom, understanding, and knowledge of what to do, what to say, how to say it. And let remind each of us that righteousness exalts the nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. We know we all have sinned and fallen short of your glory. Oh God, but you said in your word that let everyone who names the name of Christ Jesus depart from iniquity. Let us forsake our sins and our evil way and turn to you, the giver of life, the giver of forgiveness, the giver of joy, peace, amen, giver of faith, in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, for all of those who are looking unto you for a word this morning. We pray that you would touch in the name of Jesus. Now that we have celebrated the material gifts, well, God, we want to say thank you for the gift of your Son. Thank you for the gift of your Holy Ghost. Thank you for the gift of your love. Thank you for the gift of your peace. Thank you for the gift of your comfort. As we, oh God, have to deal in this mean world, but we ask God that you would touch us, guide us, and keep us. And then touch your word today. Touch the one who's going to stand and declare your word. Or speak through these lips of clay. Anoint us, upon us, empower us in the name of Jesus. And then touch our hearts that we would hear your word and receive your word and be doers and apply your word into our lives in the name of Jesus. Bless these musicians. Bless these music stamps. Bless, oh God, when we come back together again, we ask that you would just be one in our midst. And we'll be careful to give your name the praise. For we ask these and other blessings in Jesus' precious name. Amen, amen, amen. I want to remind you on the January 2nd, we will have our face-to-face service for the first Sunday in January of 2022 at 10 o'clock here in the sanctuary area. We thank God for that. So put that down on your calendar. Remember, we're mindful of the CDC protocol, so you know what to do. You know, you need to follow those protocols, the mask and all of the other things, the social distancing, and you make sure you call us and try to make sure if you cannot call us, just make sure you register before on your way in. And let's keep as safe as possible in view of the Omicron deviant derivative that's going forth. And if we want you to make sure that you get your vaccination, amen. If you're sick, if you please, we ask that you think you're sick, that you stay at home and watch us virtually. Amen. God bless, and may he keep you. Because if we can endure through the night, joy will come in the morning. Amen. We're ready to receive the word. We're going to move forth. Let's have a song by the music staff, and we'll go from there. Songwriter He's giving a personal testimony. He's sweet. I know God is good. Amen. Let the church say amen. Yes, I know I'm going to help you. Trying to let your festive digestion take place after celebration. I'm going to ask your attention to the reading of the word. Matthew, the second chapter. Try to prove out time. Second chapter of Matthew. There is one verse of scripture I want us to concentrate on, and it is verse 11. Amen. For the time's sake. Matthew 2 and 11. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless the reading of his word. For we know the grass withereth and the flower fadeth thereof, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Jesus said, before heaven and earth would pass away, before one jot or tittle of his word, his law, shall fail. I want to reason with you this morning from this thought as you have unwrapped your stuff, gifts, on your way. Some of you are on your way back to get a refund. Can I get a witness? For something somebody else gave you. Amen. Some of you are going back to exchange it. Amen. I want to ask, talk about this little thought, and that is gifts that are fit. Gifts fit for a king. Gifts fit for a king. Hallelujah. Yes, Christmas, they call it, or Christmas Mass, has come. That day of celebration has come and gone for this year. It is a day that traditionally we celebrate the coming of the greatest gift that the world has ever had. That's the gift of God's Son coming to the world for the purpose of giving his life as a ransom, shedding his blood as a propitiation, atonement for our sin. Then he rose again from the dead with all power in his hand. So, amen. That's something to really rejoice about. If, only if, you have received him. Think about that. You're celebrating his coming, and you haven't taken advantage of it. What do you have to rejoice about? Because the Bible said, Hebrews said, if we neglect so great a salvation, so it's possible for you to be rejoicing, not knowing that you really don't have anything to rejoice about right now as of yet, except God's grace and mercy is being extended and you haven't taken advantage of it. Amen. Let me reason with you for a few minutes and give the context of our scripture. Notice this, the text says, when they, who were the they? The they were the wise men, the magi, who came from the east. Because, as the song said, they had been guided by the star. Yes, a star appeared around the time of the Savior's birth. They were able to, because they had been noticing the sky. See, one of the reasons why we don't notice things because we don't study where we are. We don't notice change is because we haven't examined our surroundings. We haven't become acquainted enough with our environment. So that we become, when we are so acquainted with our environment, change becomes apparent to us. You know, that's one of the things that happens when we have bad habits. You see, when you get in the, up in the morning and you shave, for instance, talking to the men folks, every morning you have a chance to pay attention to what's going on in your face. But when you neglect, you don't pay attention, you might, help me somebody, you'll be all out of whack. You'll never look at your hair and see if it needs combing or anything. That's all that's happened to a lot of folks that are out there on the street. If H.L. Parker used to say, they just forgot. They forgot how good it felt. And they just started perpetually to neglecting things, to neglecting, not paying attention to, this change it was subtle, but it was over a period of time. If you are paying attention to what's going on around you, then you notice certain change. Yeah, why did they see that star? They saw that star because they were looking at the star every night. They were examining it periodically, come on, help me, on a regular basis. So when a new star appeared, that's something we hadn't seen before. You got to be watchful. You got to be attentive to the things in your life and examine your situation. Paul said it this way. He said, you examine yourself and see if you are in the faith or not. Yeah, you need to look at your demeanor. Look at your, examine your spiritual walk. Examine your spiritual talk. Sometimes you have to examine your environment, the folks that you are around. Help me, somebody. Amen. Because sin is subtle. It'll sneak up on you, dressed up in fine clothes. Amen. And before you know it, you are, he'll took you in. He'll get you in a situation, amen, where it's easier to submit than it is to resist. But the Bible says, resist the devil and he will flee. The Bible says, first, commit yourself, submit yourself unto him, to God, and then resist the devil. Yeah, you can't do it on your own. But he said, commit your ways unto him. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all thy ways, commit yourself unto him. Yes, they saw the star because they were observant. And they left the land of the east, and they, how many was it does not specify. Didn't say it was three. Just said wise men, magi. And they said they come and they identified the star with the coming of the Messiah, coming of the king, this new king. And the star, see, the star led them to a certain point. Led them into Israel. Led them to where Herod was, rather. And they made inquiry because he said, well, if we're looking for a king, we ought to ask a king. Can you see it? Yeah. He ought to know something about if there is a king. But what they didn't know about Herod, sometimes you share your stuff with the wrong folks. See, what they didn't know about Herod is he was as evil and as selfish, amen, as could be. He wouldn't have another king. He wasn't putting up with another king. He was wicked. It was all about him. Kind of sound like some of the things that are some of the personalities we're dealing with today. It's all about me. And they go to Herod and say, where is he that is born king of the Jews? Of course, the scribes knew in Bethlehem of Judah. Yeah, that's where he was supposed to be born. The thing they didn't have a time, did they? Daniel time and all of that. Yeah, they didn't have a specified time. So we find God is getting into the mix here. And Herod says to the wise men, I tell y'all what, y'all go search and find him. And when you find him, bring me news of who he is. Of course, he had his own motives. And apparently, they were guided so far by the star, but the providence of God led them to ask about it and go to, yeah. But we see when they leave Herod, there's a star. And when they find this, they found the star where the Savior is. Let you see. Sometimes he won't let you see what you need to see because you can't stand it right now. You're gonna tell somebody something. You're gonna do something that you shouldn't have done. Yeah, he could have taken them right to the Savior. But look at them. Yeah. So here they are in they have found the king. But it says, you can see here, they searched diligently. They found him. You can find him if you look for it. And search diligently, the Bible says, if you search him, you find him with all, and you search for him with all your heart. But notice the time, because I see here in this text, I'm just exegeting the text. It says, when they saw the young child. So some time had passed. They didn't just find him. Why you haven't found what you've been looking for, even though you've been looking diligently? Because it ain't time for, it's not time for you to find it. Because you wouldn't know what to do with it if you did find it right now. You would take it and probably do what they probably, well, send, let Herod know that, you know, we found what we were looking for. Yeah. And you got to be patient. You got to wait on the Lord. That's what happens when we don't wait on him. We got our own time. But it says there was a young child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshiped him. Our subject, gifts for a king. And they brought him gifts. So, you see, you give gifts to those that are greater. What are you talking about in our text? King is greater. Remember Abram? You remember when Abraham, when he had come from the slaughter of the kings, got Lot out, and he met the priest of God, Melchizedek, and tithed to him. Because he said, it is right for the lesser to give to the greater. And I think sometimes we just take God for granted, and we just throw up anything and think God is supposed to accept it. You know, when they, in the sacrificial system, the offerings that they brought to the God as a sacrifice should have been without spot, should have been wrinkled. He says, honor the Lord with your first fruit. Not with what left, not with what's weak and torn and left over, something you don't want. And I watch this. Watch what we do. We give folks what we don't want. But you watch this. Can I mess you up? Now, if that was the Lord you were giving it to, oh Lord, let me go to Neiman Marcus. I gotta go to Macy's. Talk back to me if you can. I want some Hickey Freeman this year for the Lord. But watch this. When you go to give somebody something, you want to give them what's left. You want to give them something not fit for goodwill. But let me really mess you up. Because he said, I didn't say this. Didn't originate with me. He said, inasmuch as you've done it to my least ones. Did that sound like you give somebody who's in need something that you throw away? Well, they ought to be grateful for anything we do. Well, you ought to be grateful too that you had it, because it wasn't yours, because God gave it to you. And you, some of us under the erroneous assumption that everything that God has given to you is for you. No, sir. But they brought him gifts. Ooh, that sets another light on giving. Notice here what they bring him. The gifts. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Let me give it to you real easy. Gold is the gift that you bring to a king. That's pretty much the top of the line in the metal business, precious metal, in that, particularly in that day. And then frankincense, gold, yeah, speak of him, the gift you bring to a king. Frankincense is yes, it's an incense. It is a spice, if you call it whatever you, yes. But you see, frankincense is, you know what they did with incense, it speaks of prayer. It speaks of petitioning to God. Help me, somebody. And then myrrh speaks of his death. Frankincense is a fragrant, speaks of his life. Myrrh speaks of his death. Paul says to the Romans, he said, you ought to submit your, present your body as a what? Living sacrifice. We want God to get us when we almost dead. We can't do nothing. Talk back to me if you can. Three things, right quick. First, I see in the text, in this context here, what you give fit for a king is prayer. Prayer, yes. How do you say prayer? A petition, a desire to see him, yeah, just to be in his presence. That is in the text where it says, and they search diligently. Come on, help me, somebody. They search diligently. Hallelujah. Yes. When they started, they were following the star. And this is a walk of faith. They didn't know exactly where they were going. And we ought to be the same way. We ought to get up in the morning and ask the Lord, Lord, what would you have me to do today? Lord, where is it that you want me to go today? Lord, who is it that you want me to meet today? What is it, Lord, you want me to do today? Prayer. 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 Yes. A desire to find his will. A desire to be in his presence. You see, you want to be in his presence, in his will. To be in his presence, out of his will, you're asking for wrath. You're asking for judgment. You want to be where he wants you to be, doing what he wants you to do. Uh-huh. Yes. That's a gift fit for a king. Our prayers ought to be sincere. Our prayers, amen, ought to be regular. Our prayers, amen, ought to be from the heart. This call, Paul said, I bow my knee unto the Lord of our, the God of our Lord and Savior, Jesus. Yes, you bring him your prayers. Yeah, can I get a witness? Secondly, watch this. I see something else. Is not only prayer is a gift fit for a king, but a present. Yes. The present, yes, speaks of, I didn't say presents. I said the present speak of the material things that we bring to the Lord. In this case, they brought gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Well, you can sit up there and talk about, well, the Lord knows my heart. That's the problem. He knows your heart. He knows why you ain't got nothing. It's because you went to the casino and spent it all. He knows why you don't have anything to pay your rent. It's because you done blew it. You ought to have something for him. I don't tell you where to go. Amen. But you ought to have a present for him. And I keep telling folks, when you come to God's house, you ought to bring him some. Just for the privilege, just for the opportunity to come in his house, to come into worship. You ought to bring him something. Gold, as I said, fit for a king. Myrrh, yeah, for his burial. Frankincense, amen. Yes, yes. Fragrance, yeah, it ought to be something pleasing to him. Hallelujah. You bring God what's left. Can I get a witness? And then want to know, we talk a question about, well, Lord, the Lord ain't blessing me. He has a blessing plan. He said, give and it shall be given unto you. Shaken together and run over. That's the New Testament. That's Jesus speaking. What did he say? Try me and see if I am not way or open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing so much so till you won't have room enough. That's Malachi, the third chapter. That's the Old Testament. Bring him something. And we categorize it into three phrases. Yeah, talent, treasure, and time. Now they had come to see a king and they didn't have anything in their hand. Anything, yeah, representing some of what they stood for. What are their earnings or other things that God had blessed them. See, giving is a plan It's purposeful. It's intentional. Hallelujah. Amen. And then there's this spontaneity of giving that ought to exist when you think of God's blessing. Lord, I didn't plan to give you this, but you just so good, I'm going to just give you this anyway. Hallelujah. And you know, you don't have to necessarily be all in God's house. It ought to be horizontal as well. Not just giving directly into God's house, but you ought to give to somebody else in his name. A mother, a single parent. Yeah, somebody in need. I didn't say folks in grief. I said in need. As you said, there ought to be a spontaneity of giving. You ought to, you walk past somebody. It's, the Spirit touches you. That's the one. You can't give everybody. You ought to give when the Lord, come on, talk back to me. Turn around and say, this is, y'all don't hear me. Then let me say this. I got to say this. I know this goes contrary to the marketing aspect of what you do. But you know what, the stuff that you do, Lord, you ought to kind of, you don't have to ring a bell. I'm going to let it soak there. If you do something for me, even in the name of the Lord, you don't have to go around and tell nobody. You don't even have to put it up there and say, we did this. Uh-oh. Help me, Holy Ghost. Think about that. I want you to think that. It's good to publicize what you're doing. But when you think about giving, and you giving to the Lord anyway, even if you're doing it to someone else. And then you think, you got to also look at the human part of it. It's not that if you help me, I'm not ashamed to, let them, somebody know. But it ought to be me who doing it. I may not want you to broadcast what you've done for me. Think about that. Because sometimes we need to put ourselves in the shoes of somebody else. Because the Lord said it like this, if we pray to our Father in secret, he blesses us what? Openly. Because see, when you do good, it'll follow you. It'll get around. Help me somebody. But when you trying to pat your, come on, talk. You know that. But he said he see it in secret. He will bless you for the good that you do will come back to you. Cast your bread out on the water and it'll come back in many days. Come on, help me. Look at that. I'm almost through. Ain't nobody shouting. They bought him material possessions. And lastly, the last thing I see, the gift of fit for a king is praise. There it is, right there in the text. It said they fell down and worshiped him. Oh, when they had opened their treasures, they came to him with something, but they got something greater. They got an opportunity to worship God. Emmanuel, for unto us son, a child is born, a son is given. The weight of the world is going to be on his shoulders. Yes. Worship. Yes. Our praise. You see, worship is a total dedication to God. When you fling yourself, when you cut loose, get about everything else, what somebody else says about you, what they think about you, and totally focus your attention on Him who is worthy to be worshipped. Now they said these were kings, but they knew they were just little kings. They were little sometime a king. They were like Herod, trying to be a king. But when they saw the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, even though he was enveloped in a baby's body, they recognized him for who he really was. That's the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the one who stood out in the space of nothing and said, "Let there be light," and there was light. The one who made the world, yeah, and whom the world consists. He holds the world together. They gave him their undivided attention, their undivided praise. And I came to tell you, if you wanna, yes, if you wanna give a gift that's worthy of a king, you give him your praise. You give him your worship. You give him your total dedication, your total focus. He said, "Enter, come in to the gates of the Lord." Can I get a witness? "Enter into his courts with praise and bless his holy name. You ought not be ashamed to let somebody know that the Lord has brought me through. You ought not be ashamed to let somebody know when I started out the first of the year, I didn't know how I was going to make it. I didn't know whether I was going to make it. But somehow, some way, the Lord made a way." And that's all I'm trying to do is tell him thank you. All I'm trying to do is tell him I appreciate it. All I'm trying to do is tell him thank you for where you brought me from. Thank you when I was down, you picked me up. Thank you when I was burdened, you lifted my burden. When I was sick, you touched my body. When I was troubled in mind, you touched my troubled mind. Yeah, when I was worried, you were my rock in a weary land. Yes, you ought to give him your total praise. You ought to give him your worship, because he's King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the first and the last, the beginning and the end, Alpha, Omega. Yeah, Jesus, Lord of Lords, Jesus. Yes, won't he make a way for you? Will you trust him? Will you trust him? A gift. Examine our worship. Examine our relationship with God. Examine our relationship with one another. And see if what we are bringing to God is fit for a king. Yes, our prayer, our present, and praise. God bless you this morning, this day after the celebration, as we move to the end of another year. We're thankful, so thankful for you being with us. And if you have felt that talk, that touch of the Holy Spirit, we ask that you can receive him right now into your heart as your Savior. if you can believe with your heart and confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, the Bible says, thou shall be saved. For faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. You believe that he died and was buried and rose again for your sins, and want him and ask him to come in and live in you, wash you clean. Receive him today and let us know of your decision to follow Christ. Amen. Bethel Missionary Baptist Church, 2106 Mill Street, Montgomery, Alabama. If you need a church home, you can contact us, 334-262-6825. Amen. And let us know your desire to become a member of this locale, of this local congregation. Amen. You can be received by your Christian experience or by letter. Amen. God bless you. May he keep you as we toward the end of another year. Until we come together again, let us be thankful. And let's pray ye one for another. Let's not forget the virtual watch service, which will be 6 o'clock. December the 31st, tune in. We have a special surprise for each of you this morning, that day. Amen. So come and join us. Amen. Although virtually. Amen. And God will, until you will get a blessing. Until we come back together on the first Sunday in January at 10 o'clock in the morning, we're saying to you, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. And don't forget to pray ye one for another. And again, until we meet again somewhere, if the Lord should tarry, amen, may God riches and bless be yours. God bless you. May he keep you from Bethel Missionary Baptist Church. Amen. And amen.